The congregation should please stand and face the west door. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our sister, Modupe Olabisi, for burial. Let us pray with confidence to God, the giver of life, that he will raise her to perfection in the company of the saints. Deliver your handmaid, Modupe Olabisi, O sovereign Lord Jesus Christ, from all evil, and set her free from every bond, that she may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God forever and ever. Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord. I have set God always before me, for he is on my right hand, therefore I shall not fall. For why? Thou shalt not leave my soul in hell, neither shalt thou suffer thy Holy One to see corruption. Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord.
I am the resurrection and the life, saith the Lord. He that believe in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live, and whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold and not another. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. For whether we live unto the Lord. And whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we live, therefore, or die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and lived again, that he might be both Lord of the dead and of the living. Let not your hearts be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. For I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor power, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Blessed are they who die in the Lord. Even so says the Spirit, for the rest from their labors. Blessed are they who mourn, for they shall be comforted.
Since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, so will it be for those who have died in him. God will bring them to life with Jesus. The Lord be with you. Let us pray together. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grants unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Thou, O God, art praised in Zion, and unto thee shall the vow be performed. Thou that hearest prayer, unto thee shall all flesh come. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. The collects. You may please kneel. O God, the Maker and the Redeemer of all mankind, grant us with your handmaid and all the faithful departed the sure benefits of your Son's passion and glorious resurrection, that in the last day, when you gather up all things in Christ, we may with them enjoy the fullness of your promise. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Please sit back.
The epistle, first letter of Peter, chapter 1, beginning at the third verse. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy, we have been born anew to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and to an inheritance which is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who by God's power are guarded through faith for salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you rejoice, though now for a little while you may have to suffer various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold, which though perishable is tested by fire, may be found to praise and glory and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Without having seen him, you love him. Though you do not now see him, you believe in him and rejoice with unutterable and exalted joy. As the outcome of your faith, you obtain the salvation of your souls. This is the word of the Lord.
Rest eternal grants unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Absorb, O Lord, the soul of thy handmaid, Modupe Olabisi from all the chains of her sins. Avenging judgment and enjoy the bliss of everlasting light.
The Lord be with you. The continuation of the Holy Gospel according to Saint John. Now when Jesus came, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb 4 days. Bethany was near Jerusalem, about 2 miles off, and many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to console them concerning their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him, while Mary sat in the house. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. And even now, I know that whatever you ask from God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in the resurrection at the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who is coming to the world." This is the Gospel of Christ.
I speak in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Please sit. Let me, on behalf of our diocesan and missioner the Right Reverend Dr. Humphrey Bamishebi Olumakaye, welcome our church fathers here present. I want to welcome specially our Dean Emeritus in the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion and erstwhile Assistant Bishop of Lagos, the Most Reverend Dr. Adebola Ademowo, PhD, FNAL, OON, and SY Mama Lagos, Mama Olunoti Ademowo, you are welcome. God will continue to renew your strength in retirement in Jesus' name. I also welcome the Right Reverend Olajide Adebayo, the Diocesan Bishop of Igbomina West, and Mama Foluke Adebayo, Mama Igbomina West. You are welcome, sir and ma. Also with us is the Right Reverend Akinpelu Johnson, the Diocesan Bishop of Lagos Mainland, and Mama Olabo Johnson. You are welcome. You are highly recognized. The Right Reverend Rufus Okeremi, the retired Bishop of Ife East. Also, the Right Reverend Akin Odejide, retired Bishop of Ifo. These are fathers who are retired, and I want to pray for them that in retirement you will not be stranded in the mighty name of Jesus. Also with us from Methodist Church Nigeria, the Bishop of Lagos Central, the Right Reverend Noti. You are highly recognized and welcome to this service. I also want to welcome all of us to this farewell service for a Christian mother, our beloved Mama Modupe Olabisi Abeke Oluwole NEE OGUNDIPE. I want to pray that God will use this service to prepare us all for eternity, which is our ultimate destiny. Whether we like it or not, we are living the stage one day. God will use this service to prepare us all for this eternity in comfort, not in sorrow, in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to condole with Mama's children, biological and spiritual. She has got a lot of spiritual children. May God be your pillar of support at this time and always. May He also grant you the grace to perpetuate the good legacies of Mama in the mighty name of Jesus. Briefly, I want us to consider Ephesians chapter 5, verses 8 and 10. For you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Live as children of light and find out what pleases the Lord. Find out what pleases the Lord. Ephesians chapter 5, from where I have picked the reference text, is from Paul's exhortation on how Christians should live in the world, not for any other reasons, but for the fact that Christ's redemptive work has changed the status quo ante by translating believers from the kingdom of darkness into His marvelous light. And that is why Apostle Paul says, because you have been translated from darkness into light, live as children of light. Paul admonished the Ephesian Christians that they have been saved from the realm of darkness for a purpose, which is to live as children of light, thereby making themselves living proofs of the things which please God. In other words, Christ's redemptive work recreated the believer to please God, and this by living as children of light. Early on in the gospel, Jesus Christ himself, in Matthew, he said, I am the light of the world, and because you are in me, you are the light of the world. Let me read from Matthew chapter 5, verse 14. You are the light of the world. A town built on you cannot be hidden. You are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Christ in this verse stresses the imperativeness of believers shining in the world. You cannot claim to be a believer and you will not shine. If you are a believer and you are not shining, you are far from Jesus. That is what Jesus is saying here. A town on a hill cannot be hidden. A believer cannot receive the illumination of Christ, who is the light of the world, and dispel darkness that is over the earth. In Isaiah's prophecy, Isaiah chapter 60 verse 2, says, see, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the peoples, but the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. Darkness is over the peoples, but the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. Describing this, the status quo before Jesus Christ came into this world. Thick darkness. But Jesus came to offer light, to shine, to dispel darkness. And in Christ's light, we are enlightened to live good lives that please God at all times. I want to talk about the life of Mama that we are celebrating today. A life lived to disseminate the light of life. She was grafted into the body of Christ through baptism when she was 2 months old. She fanned into flame the gift of God she received through the laying on of hand of bishop at her confirmation by her active and productive involvement in the Guild of Stewards, the Youth Fellowship, the Youth Bible Class, and many other organizations of St. Peter's Church, Faji. This flame she later shone as a member of Young Wives Fellowship, Diocesan Mothers Union and Women's Guild, the Cathedral Women's Guild Auxiliary, and ultimately as a clergy wife when her husband was made a deacon in 1971. And I want to believe that members of the 7 different parishes in Lagos where she served meritoriously with her husband, they have glowing tributes to her life lived to please God. Importantly, I want to refer to St. Michael's Church, Ekpe, where they left an indelible mark to bring the church and the Ajikinri into the limelight. It is customary in the clergy, when you are posted to a bush, you see people grumbling, you see them complaining, and they will not do a thing. Papa and Mama, they went there joyfully. There was no road, no toll gate, nothing, but they worked assiduously to bring that axis into the limelight. She lived as a child of light everywhere she served. Great testimonies about her passion and love for the work of God attest to her spiritually and physically illustrious life. Shining at all times. Her efforts in various capacities in various women's organizations, Cathedral Medical Society, and Lagos Diocesan Medical Commission are written in gold. The ray of our light spread far and wide, at work as a pharmacist, at home as a dutiful, loving, and caring wife and mother, and in the ministry as an encourager, an inspiration, and true servant of God. The number of people, number of attendees here today is a clear testimony. When I was discussing with the children, and they said, no, we are going to regulate, we want to follow the protocol. I said, see you, let us wait and see. Let us wait and see. All those who have benefited from a well-lived life, they cannot but come to pay their last respect. I'm sure that our life was pleasing to God. She did not disappoint God. And my prayer on this occasion is that light perpetual will continue to shine upon her. She will rest in peace. At the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, she will rise in glory. Yesterday, at the wake, the canon residentiary was talking about how she fulfilled our purpose in life. And I agree with him that Mama fought a good fight. She finished her course and very well. She kept the faith till the very end. Till the very end. Till the very end. God, we are done ahead with that crown of righteousness which he has prepared for those who lived in anticipation of his appearing, in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, it's not enough for us to just come and pay our last respect. We must learn from our life. And what are the lessons from a man's life that we can go home with today? Because this service is partly for Mama. She has done her bit. She has gone. You are still on the stage. You need to learn so that you can reposition yourself for eternity. I said it at the beginning. Whether we like it or not, no matter how you try, take your one per day capsule. Do whatever you like. Go to the best doctor for checkup. You will die one day. Death can come at any time. The old will die. I will continue to say it. The young will die. The rich will die. The poor will die. All of us will die. But one thing that is certain is that when we die, where are we going to spend eternity? And that is what I want us to dwell on now. Mama lived with a high sense of responsibility to God. Point number one. She strove to please God. Even in our old age, let the women call for a program. You see them. You see Mama. Mama will be there with them, encouraging them, prodding them to do more for God. She discovered her purpose and devoted her existence to fulfilling it. Now, let me ask you, have you discovered your purpose in life? Do you think your purpose is to amass wealth and possession? Nay. Do you think your purpose is just to go to school, work, enjoy, drink? No.
Your purpose is to please God. Because you don't own yourself. The breath of life that is making you who you are
came from God.
And he can ask you to release that breath of life at any time. What are you doing to please God? Are you living responsibly to God? Are you responsible in the body of Christ? Because some people, they are in the church, they are cog in the wheel of the progress and furtherance of the gospel. It's not impossible that you have been trying, you are struggling. Yes, I want to please God, but you can't just do it. I say to you today, you need Jesus. Remember, Jesus Christ said it. Not all those who call me Lord, 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 we do what? We enter the kingdom of God. So it's possible for you to be sitting in the cathedral, worshiping, or anywhere. And Jesus does not know you. It's possible. So you will just be there, marking time. And you think you are doing it. But no. In John chapter 15, verse 5b, Jesus Christ himself said, apart from me, you can do nothing. Apart from him, you cannot please him. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You need Jesus. And I'm presenting him to you today. Because Mama discovered Jesus early in life. In the documentary yesterday, one of the grandchildren said, Mama loved God. And that early in life. And she continued to the very end. Do you know why you need Jesus? In Ephesians chapter 2 verse 10, we are told, we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in. It is only in Christ Jesus that your being can be recreated. It's not by studying philosophy. It's not by reading the books of wisdom of this world. It is in Christ Jesus. It has nothing to do with your status in life. It is in him that you are recreated to please God at all times. And let me tell you, I'm pleading passionately. The world needs you, needs believers. See what has become of our world. See what has become of Nigeria. Nigeria needs Christians who will be Christians enough in all circumstances. Not Christians who will get into a place and they become chameleonic in everything they do. See what has become. Is it that there are no churches in Nigeria? And you see the level of wickedness, level of selfishness. God will deliver us. Our theme in this diocese for 2020 is kingdom manifestation. Mama manifested the kingdom of God. You can't go to her and you will not hear the word of God. It's not possible. Let me read from Romans chapter 8, verse 19, following. The whole creation waits in eager expectation for the children of God to be revealed. For the creation was subjected to frustration, not by its own choice, but by the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be liberated from its bondage to decay and brought into the glorious freedom of the children of God. Nigeria is waiting for you. The whole world is waiting for your manifestation. Are you ready to shine? Are you ready to do it? Are you going to disappoint God? Let me say it here today. Only those who will fight the good fight, only those who will finish their courses in life according to the will of God, and those who will keep the faith will receive the crown of righteousness at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. I want to pray for you that you will not miss your own crown in the mighty name of Jesus. So make amends. Live like Mama. Even shine more than her, and heaven will be happy with you. Be great to do this. God will release upon each and every one of us in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of God, the Father, God, the Son, and God, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please sit as we take a solo by Dupe Ike.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Christ our Lord, by his death and victory over sin, has opened the gates of heaven for his people. Let us pray that the soul of our sister, Modupe Olabisi, may come to our true home in heaven, and that God may in time reunite us all there. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all the people of God, that all who are baptized may die to sin and rise to a new and eternal life. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray that in the midst of things we cannot understand, the Lord will help us to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all who mourn the loss of their loved one, that they may be comforted in their bereavement. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all the faithful departed, that they may reign in the joys of heaven with Christ and the saints. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all who traveled, that God will grant them safe return, bless and guide them, and protect them from the dangers of the road. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all here present, that our hope be anchored on Christ, and that God may one day reunite us all in his kingdom. Lord, hear our prayer. O God, our refuge and our hope, we implore your mercy. Come to the aid of our beloved Modupe Olabisi, that she may be delivered from her sins. May your pardon obtain for her to live in eternal fellowship with thee, in whom she trusted, believed, and served. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Since we have a great high priest who has passed into the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us draw near with our true hearts in full assurance of faith, and make our confession to our Heavenly Father. Together, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbors in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate faults. We have not sufficiently walked according to the mind of Christ. We have named the name of Christ, but have not departed from iniquity. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please rise for the peace. We are the body of Christ. By one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Endeavor to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer one another a sign of peace. We offer thee, O Lord, the sacrifice of prayer and praise. Do thou receive it from the soul whose memory we this day recall. Make her, O Lord, to pass from death unto life. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, which the earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is indeed right. It is our duty and our joy at all times and in all places to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, the only Son, our Lord. For he is your living word. Through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you have freed us from the slavery of sin, giving him to be born as man and to die upon the cross. You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Through him you have sent upon us your holy and life-giving Spirit and made us a people for your own possession. And now we give you thanks, because through him you have given us the hope of a glorious resurrection, so that although death comes to us all, yet we rejoice in the promise of eternal life. For to your faithful people, life is changed and not taken away. And when our mortal flesh is laid aside, an everlasting dwelling place is made ready for us in heaven. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name forever, praising you and saying, Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he has given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he has given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross, and proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. As we look for his coming in glory, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect sacrifice. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you on earth and in heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Thank you.
we do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Let light eternal shine upon them, O Lord, with thy saints forevermore, for thou art gracious. Draw near with faith, receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
I am strong when
We take seed of faith collection.
Accept, O Lord, the offerings of your children and use it for the extension of your kingdom here on earth. These gifts are a token of our commitment to you and pledges of our willingness to serve the world, the church around us. Bless both the gifts, bless the givers, make provision for the needy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Grant, we beseech thee, Almighty God, that the soul of thy handmaid, Modupe Olabisi, which has passed from this world, being cleansed by these sacrifices and delivered from sin, may obtain thy pardon and everlasting rest through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As our Savior taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Please sit back.
The Lord be with you. It's now time to take song tribute in honor of our departed Mama. And it is my pleasure to invite members of the Cathedral Women's Guild Auxiliary to take only the first stanza of their society anthem. When you are invited, take only one stanza of your anthem. Thank you. Thank you. Sasoga, your school anthem, only one stanza. Sasoga.
Thank you.
parish awardees, cathedral parish awardees. Only the first stanza, please. If they are not there, Philip's mothers. Okay, parish awardees, okay. Thank you, Philip's mothers. Thank you, Philip's mothers. Lagos Diocesan Medical Commission. Only one stanza. Thank you. Mothers Union. Thank you, Elders Fellowship of the Diocese of Lagos, Diocesan Elders Fellowship. Thank you. The Lord be with you. Once again, we want to thank God for the life and times of Mama Modupe Olabisi Abeke Oluwole, who at this time has joined the church triumphant. We continue to pray that light perpetual will continue to shine upon her in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to recognize with us the presence of our diocesan missioner by proxy. Our diocesan would have been here, but for another assignment, he can't make it. And I want to recognize him because he's here represented by four archdeacons in the Diocese of Lagos. Venerable Julius Oyediran, the archdeacon of Lagos and vicar of St. Paul's Breadfruit. You are welcome. Venerable Sam Uye, the vicar of St. John's Falomo. Venerable John Agboru, the archdeacon of Victoria Island Archdeaconry and the vicar of the Church of Resurrection 1004 VI, and Venerable Fred Ekeke, Vicar Emmanuel Anglican Church, Mobi Road. You are welcome. Kindly give our regards to Dawsisan, that God Almighty will continue to renew his strength by the day. I want to once again recognize the presence of our church fathers who have come to honor Mama and pay their last respect to her. Our father in the diocese, grandfather in the diocese, the Most Reverend Dr. Ephraim Adebola Ademowo, ONFNL, PhD, and Mama Lagos Emeritus, Mama Olurati Ademowo. You are welcome, sir. In retirement, God, we daily renew your strength in Jesus' name. We also have with us the Right Reverend Olajide Adebayo, the Diocesan Bishop of Igbomina West, and Mama Igbomina West, Mrs. Foluke Adebayo. You are welcome. Right Reverend Akinpelu Johnson and Mama Olabo Johnson, the Diocesan Bishop of Lagos Mainland. You are welcome. The Right Reverend Norte of the Diocese of Lagos Central Methodist Church, Nigeria, and his wife, Mrs. Kende Norte, who happens to be one of Mama's children. Kindly stand for recognition, ma, because I was talking about Ekpe the other time. Mama Norte is from Ekpe. Let us celebrate Jesus. Thank you for coming. God will continue to prosper your ministry. We have our retired fathers, retired Bishop of Ife East, the Right Reverend Rufus Okeremi. Thank you for coming, sir. The retired Bishop of Ifo, the Right Reverend Aki Odejide. Thank you for coming. In retirement, you will not be messed up in Jesus' name. I must recognize our brother from across the lagoon, the Dean, Cathedral Church of St. Jude's Ebutemeta, Venerable Feyi Ojelabi. Thank you for coming. Also with the congregation, our retired father and mother, Venerable and Mrs. S.B. Akinola. Thank you for coming, sir. I recognize all brother clergy here present, numerous to mention their names because of time, and clergy wives of the Diocese of Lagos and beyond. God Almighty, we bless our ministry and we will continue to be relevant in the mighty name of Jesus. Once again, I condone with the children of Mama's sibling, the only surviving sibling. You are not alone. God is with you. He will uphold you and you will not fall. Thank you all for coming. But before we go, the choir will do something for Mama. It is by way of giving their own last respect to her, the choir of the cathedral.
Please stand for the Gloria. Please note the order of withdrawal from the cathedral. The choir will lead, followed by the clergy. The body will follow the clergy. And members of the immediate family will come after the body. Thank you. Then kindly exit the cathedral through the Bishop's Gate here so that you can get your lunch pack, because there is no reception. God bless you.